Hey guys, so today we are gonna solve a problem which is based on the Moivre's theorem. Now here we have to show that the 4nth power of 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I the whole square is equal to minus 4 raised to n, where n is a positive integer. Now guys, let me tell you that we use the Moivre's theorem whenever we want to find out the power of a complex number. So in this question, we have to find out the 4nth power, and hence we will use the Moivre's theorem to get the answer. So now, since the given complex number is not in standard form, now you must be thinking, what is standard form? So standard form means one real part and one imaginary part. So you must have heard that x plus iy is a complex number, and guys, let me tell you, that is called as a standard form. So if you see here, then r number is 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I the whole square. It means here there are two real parts and two imaginary parts. So if I want to find out the power of a complex number, then according to Moivre's theorem, we have to convert that number into polar form, and then only we can get the power of a complex number by using Moivre's theorem. So here I have two tasks with me. First is to convert that given number into a standard form. After that, we will convert that standard form into polar form, and then we will apply the Moivre's theorem by taking that power as 4n. So guys, let's start. So how we'll do it? So here the number is given this, and we have to show that its 4n power is equal to minus 4 raised to n. So I'll rewrite the question. So therefore, we want to prove that 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I the whole square whole raised to 4n is equal to minus 4 raised to n. So let's start. So now I will consider this bracket only. So equal to, so guys, you can solve here itself. So now if I want to convert it into this standard form, then I will remove this complex number or the imaginary part from the denominator. So once we eliminate that imaginary part from the denominator, then that number gets converted into a standard form. So for that, let's focus on denominator. So 1 plus 7 as it is. Now to solve the denominator, can you see here? It is in the form of a minus b the whole square. So first of all, we need to apply that formula. So a minus b the whole square is a square, that is 4, minus 2ab. So 2 into 2 into I, that is 4i, plus b square, that is I square. So guys, I am very sure that you all have done this formula in school days. Now let's reduce this. So here we will get, now let's come back to the denominator. So what is I square? So everybody knows that I square is negative 1. So 4 minus 1, we will get 3 minus 4i. So now guys, we have got a complex number in the denominator. Now let's remove it, and for that we will use a method or a process called as rationalization. So I will do the rationalization. I will multiply numerator and denominator with the conjugate of denominator. So now, let's multiply these two numbers in the numerator. So first, I'll multiply this bracket with 1. 1 into 3, 3. Now, I'll multiply this bracket with 7i. Now, in the denominator, again, we have formula, that is a minus b into a plus b, which is a square minus b square. So that will become 9, because 3 square minus 16i square raised to 4n. Now let's do the simplification. So I square is minus 1, so that will become minus 28 plus 3. It will give us minus 25. So I'll write it down on a paper. So therefore it is equal to minus 25. Now here 4i plus 21i, it is 25i, and in the denominator we will get I square, that is minus 1. So this will become minus 16 minus 1, that is plus 16. So 9 plus 16 is 25. So here 25i and here 25. So now guys, if you observe the denominator, we have removed the complex number or imaginary part from the denominator. So now it's easy. Just divide numerator separately with the real number which is present in the denominator. So here we will get minus 25 upon 25, that is minus 1, plus 25 upon 25, that is again 1, so only I raised to 4n, and here we got the number in standard form. So now we have to convert this standard form into a polar form and then apply the De Moivre's theorem. So let's start. So here I'll say let z equal to minus 1 plus I, and for this number we will require r and theta. So r is square root of x square plus y square. So minus 1 square is 1 plus 1 square is 1. So we will get r at square root of 2, and theta will be tan inverse of y upon x. So y is 1 and x is negative 1. So here we will get tan inverse of negative 1. Now this number minus 1 plus I, if I plot it on a coordinate system, then this number will lie in second quadrant, because x is negative and y is positive. So if it lies in second quadrant, then our theta must be between 90 to 180. So here if I find out tan inverse of minus 1, it is minus tan inverse of 1, so that is negative pi by 4, but this denotes that number is in fourth quadrant. So to bring it in the second quadrant, I would add pi in this. So this will give us 3 pi by 4. And guys, let me tell you, 3 pi by 4, which is 135 degree, lies in second quadrant. So you all must be knowing this method, which I had covered in the previous videos. Okay. So why we add pi? Because to bring the value of theta between negative pi to positive pi, because it is mandatory to bring that theta in between this range, so that becomes the principal value of theta, and we have to always consider the principal value of theta in the polar form of a complex number. So guys, here I got r, I got theta, let's put it here. So this will be equal to square root of 2 in bracket cos 3 pi by 4 plus I sine 3 pi by 4 raised to 4n. Now so the number is in polar form and we have power as 4n. So let's apply the De Moivre's theorem. So what is De Moivre's theorem? It says that power will remain with r. So r is 2 raised to half, because root 2 is 2 raised to half. So that will become 2 raised to half raised to 4n. And here that 4n will come inside and it will multiply this 3 pi by 4, and we will get cos 3 pi by 4 into 4n. plus I sin 3 pi by 4 into 4n. Now guys, here 4 and 4 cancel out and we will get cos 3 pi n plus I sin 3 pi n. But guys, let me tell you that you are making one mistake. Now what is the mistake? So if you'll see the question, in the question it is given that we have to prove that the value of this complex number is equal to minus 4 raised to n. It means we want that n outside the bracket, or we want that n in the power, so we cannot take n inside. So how to achieve this? So what I'll do is, see, now purposely I did this thing because I know that most of the students, whenever they see that there is 4n or some power outside and the number is in polar form, they get excited, and what they do is they take that power directly inside and they say, okay, we have applied the de Moivre theorem. But guys, that is not true. Every time we have to think as per the required result. So now in the required result, we want n outside the bracket in the power, so I will not take that n inside. So what we will do is we will rewrite this term as this complex number raised to 4 whole raised to n. So I will keep n outside and I will just take 4 inside. So guys, this will give us by de Moivre's theorem, we will get square root of 2, that is 2 raised to half whole raised to 4. So I am just taking 4 inside, and here we will get cos of 3 pi by 4 into 4 plus I sin 3 pi by 4 into 4. And guys, where is that n? So n is still outside. Now 4 and 4 cancel, 4 and 4 cancel. Here 2 ones are, 2 twos are, so we will get 2 outside. So 2 square is 4, so from here we will get 4. Here 4 and 4 cancel. So we know that the value of cos 3 pi is negative 1. So we'll get minus 1. And sin 3 pi is 0. So this raised to n. And guys, can you see here? 4 into minus 1, which is minus 4 raised to n. And that is nothing but our required result. So see here, as per the requirement, I proved that the 4n power of the given number is minus 4 raised to n. And I'm sure that you understood this video and you want to learn more videos on complex number and engineering mathematics. So guys, stay tuned, you keep watching the channel as well as the website where you can get access to all videos in sequence. Thank you very much.